Morning. I've been reviewing my list of tasks and things I need to get done as a lawyer, and I see that most of them involve being physically present with other people. Whether it's going to court for hearings or trials, conducting focus groups, reenacting scenes to prepare the case, having lunch with another lawyer, attending conferences and seminars, going to the gym to work out to relieve stress, even getting a haircut to look presentable in court. All of these things are off the table for me right now, and I think for most of us. But I went for a solitary walk this morning down to the riverfront along the beautiful Cincinnati River Walk. Of course, I noticed most of the places were closed, although a few were open for carryout. Hardly anyone was on the street, except a few walkers and joggers. It was quiet, not much happening. But I did notice that the early spring warm breeze was filled with the noise of jackhammers and construction. And everywhere I looked, I noticed workers were repairing streets and sidewalks, cleaning up debris, renovating buildings and constructing new ones. They were working on infrastructure. And they were getting a lot done in the quiet and emptiness of the city streets. And it occurred to me, that's what I've been doing, working on infrastructure. I've been digging into tasks that I've put off because I don't have time to do them during the crush of normal business, or because they aren't exciting or immediately rewarding. And I'm finding an odd exhilaration in it. I'm feeling productive, and I'm improving the infrastructure so that when things get back to normal, my practice should be healthier and more efficient than it was before. One thing I'm doing is finishing the writing projects that always get interrupted with meetings and depositions and trips to the courthouse. Instead of waiting for the deadline to stare me in the face and motivate me, I'm getting ahead of the game. I've got time to do that now, and it feels good. I've straightened up my desk and filed the little stacks that were building up. I'm feeling more in control now because I know where things are when I need to find them. And I'm deleting lots of clutter on my computer desktop. Things that I've saved there temporarily to file with court or to consult for some reason or another that I don't use anymore. I'm also fixing little software glitches that have bothered me. I'm figuring out how to correct some issues that have been bugging me for a while, figuring out how to do some things I never had time to figure out before. I installed Zoom on my phone, and I had a great chat the other day with my children who are in Washington, D.C., San Diego, Florida, and Cincinnati. Yesterday, I was called by a local news channel to comment on the growing unemployment situation, and I was able to take the time to do the interview, something I may not have had time to do before this slowdown. Now, lots of people have talked about using this time for family time, and that's wonderful, and we should all be doing that and taking advantage of the opportunity. But don't forget about the things you can do for your practice right now that will strengthen it and prepare you to hit the ground running when the courthouses and restaurants reopen, the office buildings and sidewalks are full of people again, and life starts to return to normal. Turn this downtime into productive time. Until next time, stay well.